Hello everyone, and welcome back to Pathfinder. Now, I haven't actually released any of the first part of it yet, so I don't know if anyone actually wants to see this or not, but screw it, I'm just going to keep playing it, because I'm going to be playing it anyway, so I may as well upload it. And I'm happy to. You may notice the Hungarian national anthem in the background. Well, when I was watching through the other videos, I realised it was a bit quiet and not really much was going on. So I've decided to put on the epic classical playlist on Epidemic Sound, which is a website that I've got ties to. So that means that I'm able to, or rather an account on. So that means I'm able to play all of this royalty free and you can all enjoy it in my videos. Anyway, what have we got? We've got burnt offerings. Yes. Local heroes, right? You'll remember last time I, as Kyra, excuse me, I managed to defend Sandpoint. Only just, I might add, but I managed to defend Sandpoint from the invading goblin menace, presumably sent by Nualia. Let me make that a bit bigger for you guys. There you go. And yeah, this is the next step. So, local heroes. Everyone in town wants to thank the heroes of Sandpoint for saving them from the recent goblin raid, but you have a feeling that darker times are on the horizon. Explore the town, visit its most significant landmarks, and gather your allies. You'll be needing them. Oh yeah. I have a feeling I will. Now, I'm just going to turn the volume down a bit because it's quite distracting for me. I can always edit it later in the video, but I'm listening to it live as well, so yeah. Right then, let's go for it. What have we got? So, first things first, before I do anything else, let's have a look at where we've got. We've got the general store. Look at him. If during an exploration you encounter anything other than an armor, an item, or a weapon, after the exploration you may reveal a card to explore again. That's pretty good, because that means that, yeah, it's a general store. It's going to have all those things in it, isn't it? Woods. Undefeated monsters other than villains or henchmen are banished, so that's nice. Even if I don't defeat a monster, it's going to go away. And waterfront. When playing a weapon, subtract one from each die rolled. That's pretty hefty. After your exploration, you may discard two cards to explore again. Right, okay. I've got to defeat a henchman to close that. I'm going to assume you remember the rules from last time. Oh, let me just change this. If you don't remember the rules from last time, or you haven't watched the last one, go and watch Pathfinder Adventure Card Game Scenario 1, because that's very important. This is Scenario 2. You'll miss out on the story and what happened, and I'm not really going to be explaining many rules either. I've got to succeed at a Wisdom or Survival 6 check to close that. Now, I've got to remind myself of this character. Oh yeah, Wisdom. That's good. I've just been playing with my brother, and that's a completely different character, so I'm just trying to remember how this one works. And banish a card from your hand in the general store to close it. Okay, that's fine. I think the first thing I need to do, just make sure those are shuffled, is draw my hand. Father Xantus, magic half plate, holy candle, don't need that yet, and aid. All right, no weapons, just some armor. Yeah, that's not very good at all, is it really? This is cool. It's called the Beast One. But yeah, I'm not going to say what any of the tracks are because they're about to go off screen, so I can't say them. Anyway, so the first things first then is, now I should probably have checked the rules, but I don't have them with me. I can't remember whether you turn the blessings and then move like it says here, or if choosing where to start off is something different. I think it is something different actually, so I can choose where to begin. There's two monsters there, four monsters there, and four monsters there. I think I'm going to go to the place that has fewest monsters while I try and get through all my stuff. Ah, now there is another rule. What was it? My favoured card type is Blessing. Damn it, I've got a Blessing. If you don't have a Blessing, you're allowed to read... if you don't have any of your favoured card type in the start of the scenario, you're allowed to redo it, essentially. You're allowed to redo your hand, which would be nice, but I do have a blessing, so in a way that's a shame. Cool, so if I encounter anything other than an armor, an item, or a weapon after the exploration, I may reveal a card to explore again. Well, I might be doing that, but let's just go. First things first, we grab this, and then we turn it over. Blessing of Desna. So that's to recharge a card. Let's go. half plate. Recharge this card to reduce combat damage dealt to you by 3. Banish to reduce all damage dealt to 0. So that's like this, basically, isn't it? What is the difference? There's 3 paragraphs here. If you're proficient with heavy armors, you may recharge this card when you reset your hand. Right, so mine's better, essentially. Yeah, looks like it. All right, so I've got to get a 4 in, what is it, Constitution or Fortitude. I've got a d6 plus 3 Fortitude, so I will do that. So that plus 3 gets, oh, 4. Brilliant. Okay, I do get it. That's fantastic. And what was this again? It said, if you encounter anything other than an armor, you may reveal a card to explore again. Right, okay. Well, I did get an armor. I think what I'm going to do then is discard this in order to explore again. That's one of the powers on the Blessing of the Gods. Discard this card to explore your location. So I may as well do that. Just, you know, get time, get things rolling a bit. Crowbar. Reveal this card to add 1 die to your non-combat strength check or check to defeat a barrier with either the lock or obstacle trait. Meh. But it's a, yeah, d6, and I can get to 3, can't I? Go on then. 2, plus the 1 I have for my strength. Oh no, I have 2 now, don't I? Yeah, that's what I upgraded last time. So I've actually rolled 4, which means I definitely get it. Well, another card I don't need. It's good that I've got lots of stuff, though, because that basically means that I'm going to be able to chuck stuff away without feeling bad about it. Now, I'm going to have to discard some stuff. That's totally useless. I'm going to discard it. That's less useful than my other half plates. I'm going to discard it. I'm going to also discard Father Xanthus. Because I really want to get to a weapon, so I want to have as many spaces free as possible. I might even discard that. No, I won't. I'll keep that for now. The more the stuff I discard, the more chance I'll get. Ah, damn it. More chance I'll get of getting a weapon, because I want to get a weapon in order to fight. I can always heal myself back and, you know, get those back into my hand. Okay, go to. Sorry. Blessing of Erastil. Okay, what do we got then? Add 2 dice to a combat dexterity check. Right, well, first things first then. Hang on, I just need to check something on this. If during an exploration you encounter anything other than an armor, item, or weapon. Okay, so it's not the first exploration of your go. Right, weapon then. Hang on. No, that's fine. Dog Slicer plus 1. Interesting. For your combat check, reveal this card to roll your strength or melee die plus a d6 plus 1. You may additionally discard this card to add another d6. If any d6 rolled for this weapon is a 1, count it as a 3, then discard this card. That's great! I can't remember what my other cards are like, but yeah, I'll definitely go for that. I might even use aid in order to try getting this. So discard this card to add a d6 to a check, but I won't discard it yet in case I can recharge it. I need to get a 9 in melee. So that's a d6 plus 2, plus 4, a d6 plus 4, plus another d6 from the aid, where I get another d6 to a check. So it's this plus 4, I should get it. 7 plus 4 is 11, and that means I get the Dog Slicer. That's good. That looks like a good card. Plus it's a weapon I can now use, which is great. Oh, hang on. I need to succeed at a Divine 8 check to recharge the card. What is my Divine? It's a d12 plus 2. Whoosh. Roll it old school. 10 plus 2 is 12, so I do recharge it. Wonderful. I do like a good recharge. There we go. Oh, I love my Steam controller. I really love my Steam controller. Can't explore again. Let's continue then. End of go. This way. I didn't need to reset my hand either because I had 5. Right, Blessing of Irori is intelligence check, isn't it? Right. What's next? A short sword. God, I'm coming to all of the weapons and things first. I was checking just a minute ago to make sure that I hadn't accidentally not shuffled these, because I'm getting all the good stuff first, but I don't think I have. I think I have shuffled it, because otherwise it would have blessings on top, then allies, then items, but I haven't had a single ally come up, so they must be shuffled. Just in my favour. Right, short sword. Combat check, could be good, could be bad, not really sure, certain, because I don't remember what my other weapons are like, but it's not great. If the check to acquire is 4, it can't be that good. So, check to acquire melee, it's a d6 plus 4, so I cannot fail to get it, because if I roll a 1, even if I roll a 0 on a d6, which you can't do, I still get plus 2, and then plus 1, plus 2. So I get plus 4 to my roll anyway, so I win the sword. This is good, this. Getting loads of fodder. And then I'll just discard it, basically. Because I need to reset my hand. Next. Blessing of the Gods. Right. This time. Cyrodiac Drokus. Now, my brother had this. Recharge this card to add 1d6 to your check to acquire an ally. Banish this card to return an ally from your discard pile to your hand. All right. Yeah, well, I mean, I'll go for it. Charisma or Diplomacy, 5. I've got a 6, and nothing more I can do for it. So, well, 1 in 3 chance of getting him. Nope. I don't get him, but, you know, that's fine. I'm not too bothered. He wasn't amazing. Fun, though. Look at his nose. Anyway, I encountered something other than an armor, an item, or a weapon. So, I'm going to reveal a card. There you go, revealed. In order to explore again. And yes, that is legit. Oh my god, another item. Reveal this to add a d6 to your perception check. Discard this card to examine the top 2 cards of your location deck and put them back in any order. So that could be really handy, actually, in future. So Wisdom 4. I don't have perception, so Wisdom 4. So it's a d12 plus 2, and I need to get 4 or more. 3... Plus 2. Oh, no, 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 no. It's not plus 2, sorry. That's divine. This is a wisdom check, so I didn't roll 4, so I don't get the spyglass. That's a shame. That would have been nice to have. Reset my hand. All done. 4 cards in that deck. Here we go. Blessing of Lamash 2. That's the check to defeat a monster one, and I think I've got those coming up. Well, I don't have any blessings in my hand. Oh, my God, another item. Reveal this card with... To add 1d4, it's that bloody Amulet of Mighty Fisting again. To add a d4 with the magic trait, you may not play a spell with the attack trait or a weapon on this check, so meh, pointless. Divine, though. I'll use it as health. I'll use it as fodder. So d12 plus 2, and I need to get 4. That's a 6, isn't it? Yeah, 6. I needed a 4, so yay, I get the Amulet of Mighty Fisting, which then immediately gets discarded, because I don't want it. Reset my hand. Next go. This is going to be a quick video, actually. Blessing of the Gods. Right. It's got to be a monster. Yeah, here we go. Oh, and it's undead. Even better. Oh yeah, of course. It's one random ally per location, isn't it? There are no villains or henchmen. If you acquire an ally, you may immediately attempt to close your location. If you fail to acquire an ally, discard the top card of the Blessings deck. Shit. Right, okay. I hadn't followed that. I'm so sorry. That's really bad on my part. So, I may have immediately attempted to close my location then and there. After him. How far ago was he? There was a spyglass before him. The Amulet of Mighty Fists definitely came after him, sorry, Spyglass came after him. That came after him. That was before him. Thinking back, I'm pretty sure... Yeah, so what I should do then in that case is, if I'd known, I would have tried closing the location, but I didn't know, or rather I hadn't paid attention. That's my fault, so I'm not going to go back to it. However, I failed to acquire him. So that means I discard the top card of the Blessings deck, which was one of those. So now we're at this one, like that. There we go. So I'm back to where I should be now, and I had just turned that over. So I missed my chance to close that, which is so stupid of me, but never mind. In fairness, I didn't actually acquire an ally. Yeah, if you acquire an ally. So I didn't even get the chance to do that. That's fine. Right, zombie. So, he's undead, which is great, because if you remember, add a d8 with the magic trait to your check to defeat a bane with the undead trait. So, combat 9. Immune to the mental and poison traits. Well, that's fine, it's just combat damage that I'll be doing. Half the damage dealt by the zombie rounding up. If undefeated, each other character at this location. Well, there aren't any, so that's fine. Excuse me. Okay, that means I get to start rolling. Doing some fighting. So, dog slider plus one. Reveal this card to roll your strength. So it's going to be my melee die plus a d6 plus one. Melee die is this. No, it's not. What am I doing? What is it? Melee die is a d6 plus two plus a d6 plus one. So it's both of these. No, right. I'm getting confused. So roll your melee die. Right. Melee is d6 plus four. Okay, plus a d6 plus 1, so it's basically this roll plus 5 is the damage I'm going to do to it. That's insane. And any 1s are counted as 3s. Bloody hell, what a weapon. So this plus 4, that's 19, 13. Brilliant, dead. Oh, and I didn't even roll the extra d8 that I was allowed to roll. This weapon kicks ass. Okay, so I encountered something that wasn't armor, an item, or a weapon, so I'm going to reveal a card, lol, there it is, and explore again. It's a treat. Before the encounter, discard a random ally from your hand. So it would have been an ally turned traitor, I suppose. Yep, I don't have one, so that's fine. And it's not undead, so there we are. Combat 11. Right, it's going to be a bit tougher. So, strength or melee, plus a d6, plus 1. So, I've got strength or melee, which is that, plus a d6. So it's the same deal again, this plus 5, basically, isn't it? And I'm going to get 11. There's nothing else I can do to help that, actually. I could discard my dog slicer in order to... Oh, if any d6 rolled for this weapon is a 1, count it as a 3, then discard this card. Right, so if I roll a 1 with the dog slicer, I discard the card. So that's something to consider when I'm thinking about whether I keep this or not. Good point. Anyway, let's do this. So, got to get 11. This plus 5. Bloody hell. 7 plus 5 is 12. That's fine. However, that was a 1. So that instead, that is... I could have done that in my head, but I got music putting me off. That's 9 plus 5 is 14, but it was a 1, so I have to discard that. But he's dead anyway, so that's good. And I know the last one is actually an ally. So I will, once again, reveal a card to explore again. There's the card I reveal, and I shall explore again. However, I've got to think... I've got to banish a card from my hand in order to close this. Do I want to banish anything? I don't want to banish any of these cards, really. I want to banish some of the shit that I've got in there. Well, whatever. What I'm going to do then is... I've revealed, I'll explore again. Grizzled Mercenary. Bury this card to add a d8 to a combat check at your location, so it could even be for someone else. If I was playing with someone else. Discard this card to explore your location. If you encounter a boon, banish it. Not amazing then, but I obviously want to try and win him, because otherwise... Him or her? Can't tell. But if I don't get this, then obviously I have to discard another card from the Blessings deck. So... Charisma. 6. Oh, God. Charisma 6. And I've got nothing that can help me, so... Yeah. Just got to go for it, haven't I? Come on, 6. Ah, 5, come on. Right, so I failed to get you. So I can't even attempt... Yeah, there we go. Discard that. Shame. Right, now it's closed. I immediately get the chance to close it. I choose not to, because I kind of want to keep all this. So I'll have to come back here and... Nah, fuck it, I'm gonna banish the wooden shield. I can get that back another time. It's not the end of the world losing that. So yeah, you go. Yeah, that is banished. Easy banishing. When permanently closed, on closing add 1d6 random items to this location without looking at them, then automatically acquire the top card. Oh, cool. So I get an item for free, basically, is what that says. I would do the 1d6 random items thing, but that's only if there are other cards there to choose from. Because, you know, I might acquire a monster and then I don't get anything. But because it's closed, I may as well just randomize this once and choose the one that comes up. Ready? Go! Amulet of Fartitude. Brilliant. Wish I could have banished that. Reveal this card to add one die to your fortitude check. Recharge this card to succeed at your fortitude. That's not bad, I suppose. Not bad, if I'm doing lots of fortitude stuff anyway. Anyway, that's closed. Customers could have found a little bit of everything in the town's best stock general store before I came along. Mundane goods, weapons and armour, even the occasional potion. Aside from wares both common and extraordinary, the shop also serves as a gathering place for all sorts of town gossip, and the store's owner is among the best informed and connected folks around. Good. Probably should have read that earlier, but it's alright. Get rid of that. So, I now reset my hand. Ah, still no weapons. Come on. And then, it's the new go. So, Blessing of the Gods. 21, that's not too bad. Where am I going to go next? The woods or the waterfront? I suppose if I'm going to get anything, I may as well take all the hits there now, mightn't I? Summon and defeat a bandit henchman, yeah. Four monsters, though. I think since I still lack a weapon, the woods might be a better place to go. I mean, there are still four monsters there, but even if I don't defeat them, they're banished, so that's nice. And I've got some damage mitigation as well. I can heal myself no end as well. So yeah, go on then, we'll go there. Go to the woods. Should we read about the woods? Gnarled and twisted branches support a shadowy forest canopy that allows only enough light to encourage the growth of stinging nettles and other poisonous plants. Despite the tangled plants, swift, sly things dart through the underbrush. But whether they are curious creatures of the woods or hungry predators is difficult to tell. Ooh. So, let's go for it. I did do that, didn't I? So now it's time for turning this over. What have we got? Mace. I'm pretty sure that's my current weapon, actually, isn't it? The mace. I can't remember. I'm dreadful. Oh well, I'll go for it anyway. Strength, melee, 4. So yeah, I'll do it again. I'll roll my melee die, but I'll instantly win it because whatever I get, I add 4 to, and that's enough to win it for me. So yay, finally have one of those. I'm actually going to, because I've got lots of stuff here, but now I've got the weapon to reset. Instead of resetting my hand by throwing something away, I'm going to discard this blessing in order to explore again, because I'm conscious that time is a bit on my side. What the hell is that? Dance with Squealy Nord. Oh god, it's another promotional card. If defeated, draw 1d4 random items from the box. Choose to add one to your hand, then banish the rest. So I get a random item. If undefeated, you are dealt 1 combat damage. Choose another character at your location to draw a card. Huh, well I don't have any other characters. Piggy, 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 pig, hard to ride when they get big, so catch yourself a piggy pup and ride him till the sun comes up. Okay, that's enough of that. Let's see, Wisdom 9, I could do that. Or a Combat 18, interesting. Because that's Combat Check, but 18 is a pretty tall order, so I'm not going to try that. I think I'll go for the Wisdom. Wisdom 9. I've got a D12. Oh god, even that's not great. There's not much I can do about it, really. Oh, hang on, find traps. Discard this card to add 2 dice to any check to defeat a barrier. Right, there you go. I want to try defeating a barrier, so I'm going to add 2 D12s to my D12. So, yeah, I get 3 D12s to roll a 9. This should be good. There you go. Even though I rolled 2 4s, still 18. That's not bad, is it? And then for this, I can do a Divine 8 check in order to recharge it instead of discarding it. I get 3 plus 2 is 5, so that's not Divine 8. So I don't recharge it. Okay. Anyway, I succeeded, so I get 1d4 random items from the box. Choose one to add to your hand. So let's roll the d4. 4. Right. 1. God, what the hell am I doing? 1, 2, 3, 4. May as well do this in a nice way, mightn't we? Do-do-do-do. So I get one of these 4 items. What are we then? So, Caltrops, banish this card to evade a monster whose highest difficulty is 14 or lower. Banish this card. Well, it's all banishing, so I don't really want banish things. Reveal this card to add 1 die to your disable check. Meh. Not too bothered about that. This is nice, though. Reveal this card to add 2 dice to your disable check. Okay, whatever, I don't have many of those to do. But recharge this card to defeat a barrier whose highest difficulty defeat is 14 or lower. That's not too bad. That would get me through quite a few barriers unscathed. But what's this? Bury this card to reduce the combat damage dealt to you by 2. That's quite nice. But succeed at an arcane 8 check to recharge it instead of burying it. So I'd only ever be able to use that once per go. Tell you what, I'm going to keep the masterwork tools. I've got to choose something. So I may as well, choose that. And I think that could be really nice. Zoom out, Steve, seriously. Okay, bosh. Right. That's done. Still no monsters in there. That's good. That's my go-over, isn't it? Shall I heal yet? No, I'm fine. Blessing of Phrasma. Let's see what we have. An archer. Right, here's my chance to close the location. I'm remembering this time. Recharge this card to add a d4 to your ranged combat check. Right, well, I don't think I have many of those because all mine is melee. But I'll try getting him anyway. So dexterity or ranged 8. Not happening. Charisma or diplomacy 6. I think that's the only chance I have. Yeah, charisma. That is fortitude. That's disable. Okay, I'm going to roll a d6 to try and get this. It's a 1 in 6 chance. If I don't get it, I run out of more time. If I do get it, then I can try closing, which would be great. 6, come on. Yes, get in. I mean, she's useless. I don't care about her. Right, well, that's it. Brilliant. So, I haven't even had to fight anything. This is great. Right, if you acquire an ally, you may immediately attempt to close your location. So I didn't fail, so I don't have to do that other thing, but I may attempt to close it. And to close, it's succeed at a wisdom or survival 6 check. Well, I have 12 wisdom. There's nothing else I can add to it, so I'm just going to have to go for it. But come on, 6 or more. That's a 7, yes. Oh no, it says it's a 10. I don't quite believe it, because if I drop it from there... Oh, it does roll to a 10. Fair enough. 7 or 10, I'll still take it. Still more than a 6, so there we are. So what you've got to do at this, point when you've closed is you check everything for villains and henchmen. I actually know that there aren't any in there, but you know, you've got to do it. God, look at all those evil creatures. Cool. So I don't have to fight any of them. Woohoo! Holy water sounds good, though. What was that? Oh, undead. That's fine. Blast stone. Whatever. Banish this to add a d4 to a combat check at your location. Well, that's a very basic card, that. Banish it to add a d4. And there was a trapped passageway in the woods as well. Nice. When permanently closed, no effect. So that just goes over. Cool. Cool beans. I will keep her in my hand, so I'll discard the Amulet of Fartitude, I think. How many barriers are there here? 2. Yeah, it's worth keeping that. Archer. Yeah, I will keep her in my hand because I want to be able to explore my location several times here to try and get through it. But yeah, I've reset my hand. Let's go for the next one. Blessing of Shellin is a wisdom check. Okay. So, I mean, first things first, then, I'm going to move here. Let's read about it. The bustling waterfront houses many of the community's shops and industries and serves as one of the primary gateways for travellers. Among the masts and colours of foreign ships, shipbuilders and Among the masts and colours of foreign ships, shipbuilders and fishermen rub shoulders with sailors and visitors from across the world, strangers who always bring with them exotic cargo and wild stories. Well, I wonder who the local heroes are that I'm going to meet here, then. When playing a weapon, subtract one from each die roll. That does suck. After your exploration, you may discard two cards to explore again. Which I might do, actually. I might do that, because I can heal myself. On closing, all characters at this location discard a card, and to close, I've got to defeat a bandit, which I don't think is too difficult. Well, I won't look at it too closely, because I don't know if it's open information, but whatever. Anyway, let's explore. First one, Braces of Protection. Recharge this to reduce combat damage dealt to you by one. Okay, well, that's sort of... it's not very good. Intelligence or Arcane 3. Well, I've got an Intelligence D6, so... yeah. 1 in 2 chance. Yeah, cool. I get the Braces of Protection, that's nice. Good. Now I'm going to discard my Archer in order to explore again. Why the hell not? Ooh, Explosive Runes. The difficulty to defeat the barrier is increased by the adventure deck number of the current scenario, if any. Well, I'm pretty sure that's one. Yeah, top right there, one. All right. Pow, 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 pow. This is great music. The difficulty to defeat is that. Okay. If undefeated, discard the top card of your deck. Each character is dealt 2d4 fire damage. Bloody hell, which I can't mitigate, so I could lose all the cards in my hand. That'd be a shame. Alright, so I really want to defeat this. Ah, hang on. Recharge this card to defeat a barrier whose highest difficulty to defeat is 14 or lower. Well, the highest difficulty to defeat is 10, so I can use my masterwork tools to avoid the explosive runes. Oh yeah. Oh sorry, that was 11, wasn't it? Because the difficulty is increased by 1. But still, that's better, because my dexterity is a D4 and my intelligence is a D6, so there was no way I was going to do that. Thank you, Masterwork Tools. Saved me from a lot of damage. So I recharge that. And I've avoided this, or rather defeated it. And that wasn't an ally. That's all done. I think before resetting my hand, I'm just going to use this. So I'm going to bury it, which isn't too bad, to be honest, is it? There we go. And lock it. There we are. So I'm burying that in order to... I should have read it. Shuffle 1d6 random cards from the Blessings discard pile into the Blessings deck. So that's quite nice. Okay. 1d6. Not 6. Let's roll the d6. 5! That's nice. That's good. Very nice. Okay. So we hold that. Then we go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Because I shuffled that, then I shuffled that as well, and then turn that over, and we're good to go. I've saved myself some time. Now I reset my hand. Ah, cure, just what I was after. Oh Christ, what am I doing? Right, okay. That's the one I want. Ah, there we go, mace. So it was a mace that I had. Okay, so mace. I've got two of them. Not that that matters. Let's just cast Cure on myself, I think, because I've got some blessings in there that I'd quite like back. Although, I have 6 blessings to start with, don't I? I'm pretty sure I've only got rid of 2 or 3. I'll hold on to Cure for now. There's no point in just playing it, is there? Right, I've reset my hand. Let's go. Next turn. Blessing of Torag. That's a non-combat strength check. Yeah, I won't cure myself. I'll just get on with it. Here we go. Oh shit. Enchanter. I don't like her makeup. Anyway, check to defeat 8. The difficulty to defeat is increased by the adventure deck of the current scenario. So yeah, that's 1 again. So 9. Before the encounter, the enchanter deals 1 force damage to you. And after, she's going to deal 1 fire damage to me. Now, I can never remember... That's combat damage, isn't it? No, it's not combat. Is it combat damage? I mean, it's in combat, but I don't know if 1 force damage counts as 1 combat damage. Because if it does, then I can just recharge this. Right. I will cut this bit out, but I'm going to Google it and find it. Okay, so it turns out, I've been on the official website and forums and stuff, and it turns out that that one force damage and the one fire damage is not considered combat damage. It's only combat damage if it specifically says it's combat damage. So, I can't protect it. So, before I even encounter her, I take one damage, and it'll probably be the braces of protection that I lose, actually. There you go. That's the damage done, anyway. So after she's going to deal one more fire damage, I'll probably get rid of my mace, but we'll see. Anyway, here we go. This is the combat now, so this is going to be combat damage. For your combat check, reveal this to roll your melee die, which is a d6 plus 4 and a d8. Excuse me. D6 plus 4 and a d8. There you are. And I've got to get 9. I am not going to discard this to add another d4. I'm just going to go for it. She's not undead. Yep, let's go. Oh, but I get minus one for each of the dice rolled. So it's this plus five minus two because I'm rolling two dice. So it's this plus three, essentially. Let's go. Come on, beta. That's good. So this plus three is 15. She's definitely beaten. But then she deals one fire damage to me. And that's going to be the mace. Ow. Cool. Well, that's her dealt with anyway. Cool. And then I think now is the time I play Cure, actually. So I'm going to reveal that in order to play it. Shuffle 1d4 plus 1 random cards from my discard pile into my deck, and then we can see if I recharge it or not. So 1d4. Plus 1? Yeah, 1d4 plus 1, so that's 3. Plus one, so four random cards. Shuffle, and then go 1, 2, 3, 4. Put them back, turn them back over, shuffle that, done. Then we try a d12 plus 2 to see if I can get 8 and recharge it. Oh, you bastard, it's a 4. Okay, nope, it's not recharged, it's discarded. I'm not going to discard two cards in order to explore again, so I will just reset my hand. Good, there's a nice blessing. There's the masterwork tools again. Good, that was a good go. Let's do the next one. That's for spells. To add two dice to a check if a spell was played during that check. Okay. Then we're going to explore. It's a burglar. Oh god, right, I really want to get this. Disable. Is it disable? No, dexterity and stealth. Damn! That's a shame. What's this? Non-combat intelligence check. Nah, he doesn't want intelligence. Bugger. Right, okay. Stop panicking. Two reasons. One, I want to get him so I can potentially close the location and thereby win this scenario. Not a difficult one, is it? But also, if I do not acquire this card, I discard one item, one weapon or item. Oh, I seem to remember that being worse. I seem to remember it being banish one weapon or item, but it's not. Oh, that's fine. I've got an item I can get rid of. But anyway, no, it'd be nice to get him, because then I can take on the bandit and win. So, burglar. Dexterity or stealth, 7. I've got a d4. Charisma or diplomacy, 6. I've got a d6. So I think what I'm going to do, I will discard the Blessing of the Gods. No, I won't, sorry. I'll keep that. I'll discard the Blessing of Irori in order to get one die in a check. So that's going to be 2d6. And I've got to get 6 to get this burglar. Here we go. Can't use two blessings on one check, remember? Which is why I'm not doing. 9! Very good, very good. So, I acquire him. Yay. There we are. Right. What does this say? If you acquire an ally, you may immediately attempt to close your location. I do wish to attempt to close my location. God, look, it's been no time at all. Summon and defeat a bandit henchman. Here he is. That's my bandit henchman. So, combat 8 is to defeat him. Before the encounter, recharge a card of your choice from your hand. Damn. Well, I'll recharge the burglar. Not too bothered about that. Right, now, This is where it's going to be... it won't be too tricky. So he's an 8 to defeat. And then I'll close the location when I do. So what I'm going to do then is try fighting him. So that's my strength. That's my melee die, which is a d6 plus 4. Plus... Oh, I think I did it wrong earlier. I said... I added an extra 1 to my last fight, didn't I, against the sorceress, the enchantress. Because I said plus 5 and it goes down to plus 3, but it wasn't that. It was plus, should have been plus 4, goes down to plus 2, but I won anyway, so it's fine. Got to remember that, though. I'm not using that dog slicer anymore. So strength is a d6 plus... Sorry, melee is a d6 plus 4. That's what I got there, plus a d8. And you know what? I am actually going to discard this card to add another d4, because I'd... This is the last roll of the game, essentially. I want to make sure it counts. And I'll use Blessing of the Gods as well to add another die to a check. You can believe it that I'm going to add a d8. So it's this plus 4. And I've got to get 8. Right, I've guaranteed it. Even if I roll 1 on everything, I've guaranteed it. I didn't. I rolled 15. So that plus 4 is 19. He's definitely dead. Excellent. Goodness me. Summon a defeated bandit henchman. On closing, all characters at this location discard a card. Sure. Doesn't bother me. That's it. We've got to check to see there aren't any henchmen or villains in here, but I know there aren't. There you go. Put that on there. There you go. Easy. That was slightly anticlimactic, actually, wasn't it? That's going to be one episode, basically. But there you go. That's how this game goes sometimes. I guess I wasn't explaining anything to you, and when you play by yourself, you're able to go quite quickly. So there you go. Closed. Let's have a little read, shall we? Oh, actually, nothing happened. So, yeah, I can make it up myself, can't I? So everyone in town wanted to thank us, so they did. They came along and they said, you guys are awesome. You're a hero, Kyra. Yay, well done. And I'm like, yeah, don't worry, that's all good. And I took one or two of them under my wing, and I saw the most significant landmarks, and I've gathered some allies to help me up in, what's it called? Thistletop Delve. But yeah, that's done. So... what do I get as a reward? Each character draws a random ally from the box. Right, I'm going to hit this 3 times, shuffling it, and then I'm going to draw it. 1, 2, 3. Meakindra Deverin. Banish this card to examine your location deck, and then shuffle it. Oh, wow, that's cool. That's really cool. I mean, it's banish, which is a shame, especially since that's my only ally. I kind of want to keep Father Xantus, actually. But that's great as a one-time use, isn't it? Yeah. Okay, let's have a look at what I've won, shall we? 1, 2, 2. I'll show you the making of the deck, because that's part of this game. Making sure I've got all the stuff that I want. I didn't get to half of these cards. Did I? I've got so many. Won't forget my buried candle over there, my holy candle. Come on. So many cards. Seriously. Right, okay, good. And then we'll unlock you and turn you round like that. I will move that as well, because I need to be able to see it. So, to make my deck, I need 2 weapons. I've got about 50. Okay, so I've got quarterstaff. Strength or melee plus a d6. What's this? Strength or melee plus a d6, and I can discard to add a d4. Meh, not great. I'm not proficient with weapons either, so that's not going to help. This dog slicer is great. Strength or melee plus a d6 plus 1. No, it's not that great, is it? Because it's not reliable. I need reliable things like the quarterstaff and the mace, I think. I'm going to stick with those two. Boring as that may seem. There you go. 2. Next, 3 spells. I don't think I changed any of my spells there. So it's Cure, Find Traps, and Aid. That's easy enough. Oh, a nice bit of chamber orchestra to see us off. Armor, 2. No, I had to banish one of my armors, didn't I? But that's okay, because I've got half plate and I've got magic half plate. I don't think I have any other armor there. No, all those are that's item, isn't it? Yeah. Yep. Okay, even the braces of protection are an item. But yeah, those are my two armors now. Kind of wish I still had the shield. But I can't just take it back. One item and one ally. Right, let's take the ally first, because I'm pretty sure I know what it's going to be. Oh god, I say that. Got four to choose from. Burglar's nice. But I've got Masterwork Tools. Mayor Kendra Deverin. Banish this card to examine your location and shuffle it. Recharge this card to add 1d4 to your divine check. Yeah, he's another heal. I'm tempted to stick with him. No, you know what? I'm going to go out on it. I'm going to take her. That's really useful. Plus, if I have to banish a card and then at the end I'm drawing and I don't have any allies in my hand, in my deck, I get to choose one. I get to choose a basic one from the deck. So I can just choose Father Xantus back again, actually. So that's good. Right, that's those three done. What else do I need to do? Item one. Well, it's going to be the Holy Candle. As much as I like the Masterwork Tools, they helped there, but the Holy Candle is just too good to get rid of. What now? What now? Oh yeah, sorry, I just zoned out for a second there. Six blessings. So, we take one of each, and then fill it up with gods. 3, 4, 5, 6, there you go. Do-do-do-do-do. I have a feeling I recognise this for some reason. There you go. That is that episode. And that scenario, in fact. So, to give you an idea of what I'm going to be playing next time, it's going to be, not Thistletop Delve, Trouble in Sandpoint. Yeah. Let's whack these together. Do, 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 do. I definitely know this. Do, 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 do. So yeah, that shit's going to be going down next time. So you'll have to come and see if you want. You have to come back and watch if you want to see that. And what's at stake, huh? What's at stake? Each character gains a power feat. So I'll get to tick that or one of those. That's pretty important, actually. I could have a hand size of 6. That'd be really good. Or weapons proficiency. That might be nice as well. But that's for if and when I beat the next scenario. So, I bid you all adieu. Thank you so much for watching. Do let me know if these are shit and you don't like them. I'm probably going to carry on making them, because I'm going to be playing these games anyway. But yeah, don't watch them if you don't want to see them. But I love it. So anyway, thanks for watching this 50-minute long episode, roughly. And yeah, see you next time. Bye. Let's drop this a sec. How do I drop it? That's that button. Smash!